The question reads that the model of the nuclear atom was first proposed by Ernest Rutherford. He developed this model on the basis of results obtained from an experiment using gold metal foil. In part A, complete the table with the information for two of the particles in an atom of Au, which is gold. The atomic mass is given. It's given as 197. The first thing that needs to be looked up in the periodic table is the proton number of Au, which is 79. So Au is 79 with an atomic mass or nuclear number of 197. So if fill this table over here, the relative mass of neutron, this is a very basic question, is 1. The relative mass of proton is also 1. The electron is 1836 times lighter. So its relative mass is 0.0005. The relative charge on a neutron is 0. It's neutral, and the location of electrons in electrons are always present in shells, and we had to figure out the number of neutrons in an atom of gold. So it would be the neutrons are found by subtracting the atomic mass and the proton number. So 197 minus 79 gives me 118. So this was a very basic part, and it's for 4 marks. It's 4 easy marks. Let's move to the next part of the question. The next part of the question is state the type of bonding in gold. Now, gold is a metal, so this is a simple question as well. It's metallic bonding. So it's going to be forming a giant metallic lattice with free moving electrons. Let's move to the next part of the question, which is a sample of gold found in Earth consists of only one isotope. Explain what is meant by the term isotopes. So isotopes, the definition of an isotope is that they are atoms of the same element with the same number of protons. They have the same exact protons, but different number of neutrons. So neutrons can vary, but the rest, the protons are going to be exactly the same. Let's move to the next part of the question, which is that a different sample of gold contains more than one isotope. Suggest why this different sample of gold has the same chemical properties as the sample found in Earth. So the reason why different isotopes have the same chemical properties is because by definition isotopes have the same number of protons and electrons, so they share the same electronic structure, so they're basically the same element and they're going to react in exactly the same way. Having different number of neutrons are neutral, they don't attract or repel, so neutrons have very little role to play in a chemical reaction. So changing the number of neutrons only will not affect the chemical properties of an element, because it is still going to have exactly the same electronic structure. So different isotopes are going to have exactly the same chemical properties. Now part D of the question reads that tumbaga is an alloy of copper and gold. A sample of tumbaga was analyzed and the mass spectrum of the sample is shown. Now, what does the mass spectrum tell you? Mass spectrum basically detects the percentage composition of different substances in a compound. So this over here is the mass to charge ratio. So you have a substance with a mass of 197. You also have a substance with a mass of 65. And you have a substance with a mass of 63. And the percentage composition or abundance is given. So 63 is 56.36%. The substance having mass 65 is 25.14%, and we don't know what percentage abundance is or what percentage composition is tumbaga that contains this substance. Now we need to calculate the percentage abundance of gold X in the sample of tumbaga. So this element or substance having a mass of 197 is gold. That's what we just discussed in the previous parts as well. This is gold. So all the substances or the elements that are part of tumbaga, their percentage composition must add up to 100%, which means that 56.36%, 25.14%, and X percent, which is given over here, if I add them up, that's going to give me 100%. So 56.36 plus 25.14 plus X, they should all add up to 100% of tumbaga. And if I solve for X, would come out to be equal to 18.5%. So this is the working that I'm going to do for this part, and the answer X comes out to be 18.5%, which means tumbaga has 18.5% gold. Let's move to the next part of the question, which is use the relative atomic mass AR of the copper present in the sample. Give your answer to two decimal places. So the first thing is Let's go back and have a look. Copper, remember, has a mass, an average AR of somewhere around 63 and 65. So these atoms, they must be copper. So you have two types of copper. One has a mass of 63. The other one has a mass of 65. We're going to ignore gold. Remember to ignore gold. We need to find the average relative atomic mass of copper. So 63 is 56.36%, 65 is 25.14%. And get rid of the gold, the 18.5% of the gold. Just remove that. We just need to find the average of this. So the way you're going to find the average is, so the formula of AR is written. It's basically the percentage composition multiplied by the isotopic mass. And you're going to sum them up and you're going to divide it by the total percentage, which usually is 100%. But in this case, it's not 100% because we need to remove gold from our calculation. So our total percentage is going to be of the two substances would come out to be 77.5%. So I'm going to do this calculation now. So it's 63 into 56.36%. Then 65 into 25.14%, and I'm going to sum them up and divide by the total percentage, which in this case is not 100%. Remember, you ignore gold. Gold should not be part of the formula. It's a different element. We just want to find the AR of copper. So if you add up the percentages, it's coming out to be, the total percentage is coming out to be 81.5%. So this is how I'm going to calculate the average AR of copper, and that comes out to be, and on my calculator, the value that comes out to be, it's coming out to be 63.62. So that would be the average AR of the copper based on the graph that's given over here. So it's 56.36 multiplied by 63 plus 25.14 multiplied by 65. Get rid of the gold from the whole formula. Don't use gold. You're calculating the average of copper, and you're going to divide by the total percentage, which comes out to be 81.5%.